next question is regarding the formation of gravitational waves. Now, gravitational waves, it's a current affair related topic, and it's one of the most important discoveries in this century, right? So the gravitational waves, it was predicted by Albert Einstein in 1916, and we were able to, you know, directly observe the or directly discover the gravitational waves, and that's why this discovery is very important. And like I have again covered the gravitational waves in one of the current affair videos, so you can check for the video in our channel. So this question is regarding which of the weather events can result in the formation of the gravitational waves. I mean, speaking about the importance of gravitational waves, in the previous year, right, in the 2017 prelims examination, gravitational waves was in, I mean, a question regarding the gravitational waves was asked, right? So for that reason, this year you can further expect a detailed question regarding the gravitational waves, plus it's in current affair too, right? So in the 2017 it was discovered twice or thrice, right? Now it was again discovered for the fourth time in, and for that reason, right, the gravitational waves, the topic is important. So going through the question, gravitational waves which are predicted by Albert Einstein in 1916 in his general theory of relativity, right, all of those things, they are important, are ripples in the fabric of space and time. As gravitational waves carry with them the information regarding their origin, its discovery could herald a new age of gravitational astronomy. Now the importance is that if a gravitational wave is, I mean, if you are discovering a gravitational wave, we will understand how it got originated, right? For example, think about the sun, right? Now we haven't directly gone to the surface of the sun, but we know the temperature of the surface of the sun. How? In the sense, analyzing the light coming from, or the radiation coming from the sun, right? If you could analyze the solar, I mean electromagnetic radiation coming from the sun, it's like, you know, we are studying the properties of the sun. Same way, if you are studying gravitational waves in detail, it's like studying the origin of those gravitational waves, right? And that's why it's important in astronomy. Now in this context, consider the following. And there has been four options given here. Which of the above given event or events could create strong gravitational waves? So the question is regarding which of these four options can create strong gravitational waves, right? To understand this, right? Now, this is the picture of an Earth. It's an artistic picture, right? Not a realistic picture. Now, the planets or star, everything is occupying a space, I mean, occupying a region in the space, right? And that region we call it as space and time fabric, right? So what happens is that when the mass is concentrated, like say planet Earth or a star, like their mass is being concentrated, right? When the mass is being concentrated in one place, this space and time fabric, it will get bended, right? Now imagine this, the Earth is moving, right? So this bending is also moving, right? Now this can create gravitational waves, but such gravitational waves which are created by planets like Earth, which are having very less mass, right? In astronomical terms, the Earth is having very less mass. So in that case, the gravitational waves will be very feeble and it cannot be detected, right? At the same time, think about two black holes, right? Two black holes, they're moving or they're spiraling, right? They're not staying at one place, rather than they're moving, right? So that will create or that will distort the space and time fabric, and such events can create the gravitational waves. So gravitational waves, if you are being, you know, absolutely asked which of the events can create gravitational waves, even a movement of an aeroplane can create a gravitational waves, but it will be very negligible, it will be very feeble, right? At the same time, right, movement of black holes, or like say Big Bang itself, I mean, as of now we believe that the universe evolved, right, or originated through Big Bang, right? Big Bang was a sudden explosion, and that sudden explosion would have disturbed the space and time fabric. Or for example, right, another example, imagine a star is colliding or bursting, right? That can also create or disturb the space and time fabric, in turn resulting in the gravitational waves. So simply saying, the gravitational waves, it means their energy transfer taking place in the universe. When an high energetic event takes place, that energy will be transferred through the space in the form of gravitational waves, right? Now let's go back to the question. So in this context, consider the following. Which of the above given events or events could create strong gravitational waves, right? The first one, movement of the Earth around the Sun. Now movement of the Earth around the Sun can create, I mean ideally can create gravitational waves, but as I said before, it will be very feeble, right? The question is regarding which can create strong gravitational waves, and for that reason the first one cannot be the answer. and we can eliminate it from the options, like we can see, A as well as C can be eliminated, and from that we understand that the second as well as third statement is correct, right? Because it's there in both B as well as D, right? Anyway, let's go through the second statement. When two big stars orbit each other, right? When two big stars, when they are orbiting each other, right? So big stars itself means like, they are having more mass, right? When they are moving, they will be creating like, the gravitational waves. Imagine like, two big stars, they are orbiting each other, right? They will be attracted to each other, but they won't collide, right? They will start to spiral, right? And that can create the gravitational waves. Moving on to the third statement. When two black holes orbit each other and merge. The thing is like, imagine two black holes. They're having huge mass, right? When they attract, come towards each other, right? They will start to spiral, and there will be a moment when they collide each other and they will merge, right? In that scenario, the gravitational waves or high energy will be released in the form of gravitational waves. Now, in 2016, when we discovered the gravitational waves, right? The first set of gravitational waves which we could discover was created because of the collision of two black holes, right? So the third one can create the gravitational waves. Then the fourth one, origin of the universe through Big Bang. Now Big Bang means sudden expansion, right? Sudden expansion means it can be seen as the universe is bursting, right? Every mass, right, everything like the planet, star or the hills and everything, right, we see around us, every matter is believed to have constituted in one single point in the origin of universe, right? And from that one single point, it started to explode, resulted in the origin of universe. That's what Big Bang says, right? So this sudden expansion or explosion can create like the gravitational waves. So here the answer would come out as B, which is 2, 3 and 4 only, right? Now why the first one is not correct? Because like, the question is like, which can create the strong gravitational waves. Now the strong gravitational waves can be created only when we are having high energetic events taking place in the universe, like black holes colliding or supernova explosions or like say Big Bang itself or two big stars coming together. Like, such events can create strong black holes.